Hello there, everybody. Dingo Crash here, and today we're back with new part of Sly Cooper. And today we will be heading to the last area.
Okay, partner.
To the last area.
We were on our way to the Krakarov volcano in Russia. While looking over what little information I had on the final member of the Fiendish Five, I began to notice something. In the four parts of the Thievius Raccoonus recovered so far, several of the pictures depict a shadowy owl-like figure, which looks very similar to the police images of the mysterious clockwork. Is this a strange coincidence, or is there something I'm missing?
Yeah, so it's this stage is gonna be called Cold Heart of Hate.
Whoa,
now, this is gonna be the last area of this game, and I'm not gonna split this into parts. I'm gonna actually name the areas in the description. Now, yeah, this is gonna be a really interesting part, since this is leading our way to Clockwork. Which is, you know, it's quite interesting, like, it's quite amazing. I personally really like this area, though it could be a little bit difficult. Just like these owls, they would fucking, they would try to, if you don't hit them right in time, then you're most likely gonna be fucked. So you don't want that to happen. Yeah, those owls are gonna actually return. Those owls are gonna actually be returning every time as we progress and shit like that. So you might want to be careful when you're around here, and you want to keep your eyes open and more like learn to control the game in a correct way. To the point where you don't have to deal with this bullshit. And, yeah, we'll have a little bit more owls, ambushing us. Ooh. I actually used to hate this part, but I learned how easy it is to the point where it's just, like, nothing, to me. So, well, it is something. It's just that it's gonna get a little bit difficult.
Nice shooting, Sly! Looks like we're in the clear!
Murray, that cave doesn't look tall enough for the turret to make it all the way through!
Well, that was interesting.
We've got to get through that security door on the far side of the cavern. The only way to unlock it is to analyze at least 60 of those hanging computers.
Would have been easy to get at them if Murray hadn't thrashed our new turret.
Yeah, won't be a problem. I can hack the computer's connection coupling so they'll fall to the ground. Then, Murray will have to run over them with the van.
Okay, and Murray, remember to use our new battering ram by hitting the square button if anyone tries to keep you from those computers.
Yep, so this is gonna be a very interesting part. Those little enemies will try to take these computer screens away from us. Now, try to kill them, try to demolish them before they take any computers out, because that way they're gonna be in the lead and they're gonna destroy our pretty much our progress of getting all of these computer screens out of the way. Now, this is an incredibly easy challenge. It's just that you know when to really attack and all, because otherwise it's gonna be really difficult if you don't know what you're doing. Right now we're actually doing very well, but remember to use the square button to push them away in order to actually survive this heavy attack that we're under. Otherwise, we're gonna be fucked, technically. And we're actually at 51 out of 60, which is great, because we're about to get them all. Alright, let's see.
Are we going to make it?
Yes, we did!
Woo! We have enough data to open the security doors. Just past them is the control room to Clockwork's Death Ray Tower. I think it's time for some Cooper thieving and sabotage. Don't you think, Sly?
Yes, we do. So we're past two areas without dying. No, let's not jinx it. No, this is going to be a hard part. Oh, no, sorry.
Careful, Sly. Those tiles are booby-trapped. You better get out of there.
Hold on. That's Carmelita. She looks trapped.
Serves that cop right. She's been dogging us from the start.
It's just a misunderstanding. We've got to free her.
Are you crazy, Sly? Clockwork probably stuck her there to trap you.
But if I don't do anything, Carmelita's doomed. Besides, stealing just won't be any fun without her.
Sly, your ridiculous raccoon logic sends shivers up my shell. But if you're determined to go through with this, that barrel will undoubtedly help, though I have no idea how you'll get up there.
Dude, a spire jump here, a rail slide there. I've done this a million times.
Yep, Sly is an expert at thieving. Technically at parkour, that is. So yeah, this is the third area where we will have to actually free Carmelita because she is imprisoned. And there's gonna be a part where we are not going to like very much. Especially because of certain things that will be happening during the time that we will rescue Carmelita. Now, yeah, this barrel is great and it's very helpful for us. It's just that you'll need to know... Oh shit, that was a bad idea. Woo-hee! Yeah, this was kind of a bad idea to do this. Ah, shit. No, are you fucking serious? How the fuck did I fall all the way down there? Am I gonna fucking get back into the barrel? Fucking Christ. Well, jinkies. I fucked myself over by this stupid-ass piece of shit of a course. This is such an easy area. I remember doing this on the first try. And right now I just fucked myself over. Good lord. My throat is fucked up. This part is gonna be... It's a very easy part. I'll tell you that. It's an extremely easy part. It's just a trying to actually do this without getting hit at times. It's gonna be annoying. I'm telling you that right now. Especially when you need to know when to stop moving and when you can continue moving. Right now I did a shitty job at doing this. Yeah, this is gonna be a really annoying thing to go through. And we've actually managed to go through it with no problem. What the fuck? What the hell?
Sly Cooper, I should have known you were behind this.
You got me wrong, Miss Fox. I'm here to rescue you.
You sentimental fool. Empathy has always been the downfall of the Cooper clan.
I knew this was a trap. Looks like I'm going to have to do some fast and furious hacking to shut down that gas before Sly's brain is turned to cheese.
Yes, that is bad. Now, this is the part where it gets extremely difficult. This is the part where we actually hack the system. Oh my god, you're talking too much, Bentley.
Looks like I triggered one of Clockwork's security algorithms. Stay sharp, Bentley.
Yeah, stay sharp, Bentley. Technically, the player. Now, yeah, this is gonna be an extremely hard part. Not an extremely hard part. It's just gonna get a little bit difficult. Oh shit! It just began and already fucked up. Yeah, this little virus thing that attacks you. Yeah, I did a marvelous job preventing from getting hit. But you actually need to be careful and not to get hit by it at all. I know it's very difficult. I mean, it's not that difficult. I mean, once you get the hang of it, this is how Sly Cooper games have been. Like, it's really easy to get the hang of the gameplay. And it's just that you need to know to go through these stages in a certain pattern without getting hit at all. It seems like a big deal, but it really isn't. Now those red things is what you really want to avoid out of everything, because that will kill you in seconds, which is one of the annoying parts about this boss fight. I mean, not boss fight, but this hacking part. Now, level 4 is actually the last part that we will be having to deal with. Now, yeah, that fucking virus thing is after us. Now, oh shit, that was close. I'm really scared. I really am scared because of this part. Because he'll follow you and he'll try to destroy you at any cost. And I really hate that. Obviously, we all do. I mean, we've all had to deal with that bullshit when we've played Sly Cooper. And we've got the last part, nearly. Woohoo!
Wait! No code can stand before thee.
Yep, we did it. Holy shit!
Sly, I was wrong about you. Break me out of this force field by smashing its base, and I'll make it up to you somehow.
I don't know why, but this music reminds me of Sims music. But here we go. We're heading towards the next area.
I don't get it, Cooper. I've hunted you for years, tried to throw you behind bars, but when you get a chance to leave me in a cage, you set me free. Why?
Carmelita, we may be on opposite sides of the law, but you're not my enemy. Now, the homicidal robotic owl that built this death ray and nearly gassed us to death? That guy's on my list.
I see your point. All right. Until Clockwork and his evil schemes are destroyed, I suggest we work together.
Together at last. Wait, I need that cane. It's been in my family for generations.
Don't worry, Ringtail. I'll cover you while you get it back. If you can, make your way to the top of the Death Ring. I stashed my jetpack there before Clockwork nabbed me.
Now that we're a team at all, I need to leave your side.
Hold on. This truce is only temporary. Once we beat Clockwork, I'm coming after you.
Really?
Well, maybe I'll give you a 10-second head start.
This is very interesting. Alright. So, yeah, we're going to go through this disastrous thing where we're gonna actually get Sly's cane back, and wow, I forgot that enemy is gonna come after us at that point. I love how it's like, it has this music of like some hell kind of bullshit. So yeah, this part is gonna be extremely easy, even though I just died, because I actually forgot that little thing, those sludge thingies, whatever they are gonna come after us. Shit is gonna be very intense during the boss fights. The boss fight. Now, if there is something that I loved about this area is how everything really connects to one another, Now, what I really recommend is destroying everything from here to there. Because that way, it's going to help us actually go all the way through without having to deal with enemies. Oh shit. This is cray cray. Yeah, he got it! Woohoo! Yes. We did a little shortcut. And here we are in one of the last parts.
There's Carmelita's jetpack right where she said it would be. The magnetronic support field for the death ray got destroyed as you were making a run for your cane. You'd better hurry, this whole thing is about to fall apart.
I'm on it.
So yeah, in this part, I suggest to actually avoid as many obstacles as you can, even though that's what we're going to be doing.
It's sinking fast. Climb.
Yeah, like this area is going to be sinking really fast, and we have to make our way really fast up there. And I consider this part kind of difficult due to the fact that, like you need to time everything, literally. You'll have to time every single jump and every little thing that you do, because this gives you a little to no time to make it up there without dying, which is crazy. And as you can see, we are already about to sink to death under this lava bullshit. I know that if you die too much, the lava won't go up faster, like it will actually go up slower. In this case, it's kind of difficult to avoid all of this, since it's like, fuck, I knew I was fucking going to die around this point, for fuck's sake. And the funny part is that it's at the last bit of this area, which is bullshit, because I was doing extremely well. Don't you love it whenever you're doing extremely well? Now, if there's something I want to ask you, Let's Players out there, do you ever re-record once you fuck up really badly on a certain part of a game, of a Let's when you're Let's Playing? Because I'm really wondering, like, if there's anybody who do this. Because I know I did. I did. At certain times. Back in the day, I used to do that. And it was something that was, you know, kind of annoying to do. Because I know that people love to see people rage. And, well, I certainly did not love it whenever I raged my ass off during Let's Plays and shit like that. It can be really irritating at times. It's just that, you know, we all have our moments, that's for sure. And we're finally done with this area. Now we're heading into the last.
Okay, that jetpack is easy to fly. Use the left analog stick to aim and steer, and press the square button to fire its rockets. Sly! Behind you!
Sly Cooper, you have escaped my gas chamber and destroyed my death ray. Remarkable. You Coopers always find a way to beat me.
Always? So that was you in the background of all those old pictures in the Thievius Raccoonus. How old are you?
Perfection has no age.
What? You're immortal?
Revenge is the prime ingredient in the fountain of youth. I've kept myself alive for hundreds of years with a steady diet of jealousy and hate, awaiting a day when I would finally eclipse your family's thieving reputation.
Sly! My missiles don't hurt him, but seem to create holes in his armor. Shoot into the gaps I create!
Yep, so, right now we're actually fighting Clockwork. And this boss fight, I must say, is not that difficult. And compared to most boss fights that we've fought, this one is piece of cake. Even though it's a very interesting, boss fight, because we kind of get to know a little bit more of the historical background regarding the Cooper family. Now, yeah, some of the times this shit is gonna get a little annoying.
Get it. You're so familiar with my family. You must have known my father had a son. If you hated the Cooper so much, why did you let me live when you stole the Thievius Raccoonus?
Because I wanted to show the world that without your precious book, the Cooper line was nothing.
Ah, well, there's where you're wrong. The Thievius Raccoonus doesn't create great thieves. It takes great thieves to create the Thievius Raccoonus.
Enough, sly Cooper. It ends here. I will finish you like I finished your father. And the Cooper line will be erased, and the only master thief will be Clockwork.
Yeah, Clockwork is a very meanie. He's a real meanie. And we will have to, Oh, are you serious? I actually got... Oh my god. This is bullshit. Yeah, if you die... Then you'll have to actually do this. You'll have to actually do this again, which is the annoying part. I cannot believe I just fucking died there. This is bullshit. Yeah, it's like I was doing well until that part. That was bullshit. Like this game can be like, this boss fight is easy as hell, it's just that, like, the controls sometimes can be very annoying. Alright, so, we're finally done with that part. Now, let's head towards to one of the last parts. Well, it goes into, like, three different sections, if I believe, if I'm correct. Alright. Let's demolish it! Woohoo!
You're the weakest Cooper I've yet encountered.
How the fuck am I the weakest Cooper? I'm defeating your ass. Fucking bullshit. He's the weakest. Here. Alright. One of the few more hits. We're good to go. I'm scared. I'm literally scared to miss those rings. All right. Mm-hmm. All right. Let's see. Woo-hoo. Now, this is one of the last bits.
I am.
Okay.
Blue 7. Flowers.
What?
Never. Lava tomb. Lay. Feet together.
Oh, are you serious? Do I have to do this all over again? Yes, we do. For fuck's sake. Oh my god. This is bullshit. I hate doing this over again. I was doing well until that point. I literally forgot, like, it's... How the fuck is it possible to finish him without having the horseshoe. Like, I never understood that. Like, how the fuck is that possible? It's nearly impossible to do that without the horseshoe. I think if I'm gonna die again, I know that once you're about to hit like a game over, you will be able to actually do this with no problem. It's just that, you know, this shit can get rather intense. Alright. Come on. We can do this! And here we are. Just a few more hits. I know I can do this. And... holy lord. I'm scared. Oh shit. I'm even scared to commentate because of this fucking boss fight. It's crazy.
You cannot escape me, Tumble Raccoon.
Yes, I can. I proved many times to be doing so. All right, to the last bit. Wish me luck, guys. I'm scared to death.
I am. Blue 7. Flowers.
No! Are you fucking bullshitting me? What the fuck? Oh my god! I cannot believe I fucked up that jump. Fucking bullcrap! How the fuck did I fuck up that jump? Oh my god. This is pissing me off. I was doing incredibly well until that bullshit happened. Ugh. I fucking hate when crap like that happens. It's this bullshit that pisses me off. Alright, let's take it down his stupid ass wing. And now we're gonna do the second verse. Again! Ugh. At least I have the second round perfected too. So that way I don't have to deal with bullshittery. Well, I hope so. I'm scared to commentate, I really am. I'm scared of talking while I'm concentrating. Cause it's fucking hard to actually do this. And without getting hit at all. Come on, just one more, two more rounds, and we're good to go. All right, one more hit. Oh shit. Ah, fuck. Alright. I love his face and the little icon below. It looks weird, but it looks kind of funny. Alright. I hope so. Please, for dear God.
Blue 7. Flowers.
What?
Never. Lava tomb.
What the fuck? Nothing like pushed me away.
Feet together.
Oh, there you go. That's how you do it, stupid as me. I was doing it wrong.
Immortal. Direct energy.
Come on!
You will never be rid of me. Clockwork.
It took some tricky maneuvering, but I managed to snatch that last piece of the Thievius Raccoonus from Clockwork's claw. I had taken down each member of the Fiendish Five. Raleigh, Mugshot, Ms. Ruby, the Panda King, and finally Clockwork. I'd beaten them all one by one and reclaimed my birthright. Of course, there was no way I could have gotten here without the help of my pals. I know this hasn't been easy for them, yet they stuck with me through it all. Murray.
Boy, it took a lot of guts for him to get out in the field with me. I know he was scared, but he's got more heart than anyone I've ever known. And thank goodness for Bentley. Without his expertise, I'd have never found my way off that rooftop in Paris. A guy couldn't ask for a better gang of friends. Who could ever forget the lovely Carmelita? Looks like we're not going to be friends anymore. Now the Clockwork's death ray is out of commission. We're back to playing cops and robbers. I thought for sure she was going to slap the handcuffs on me right then and there. But instead, she was true to her word and gave me that 10-second head start. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. One. I felt bad leaving her stranded on that giant rock, but I knew it wouldn't be long before we'd see each other again.
So yeah, we're finally, we have finished the game, but it's not all, since we have to actually beat the time trials, and then we will have to actually, I think we will have to actually go and defeat the boss again, I'm not too sure, but this is awesome, finally coming to an end of this Let's Play. And and actually, at a certain point, I will move towards Sly 2. I just don't know when. I kind of need to play the game all over again since I haven't played the game for a long time now. So yeah, that's awesome. Now, as I said. to you guys before in one of the parts, the time trials are gonna be a little bit difficult to actually go through, and I think there's gonna be a little cutscene happening in a second. Yep. Apparently he's still alive.
I hate to tell you this, Sly, but the Thievius Raccoonus isn't fully restored. You're gonna have to go back and unlock all the vaults to find the pages you're missing. There is some good news, though. A friend of mine in Japan just sent me this really cool movie. And guess what? It's all about us!
Oh boy.
Yeah, 危なかった. Ma, Karmelita-chan には 悪いけど, 今回も俺様たちの 勝ちだ. この名誉にかけて狙う悪党のみ全人からは奪わない。ところが俺様が秘伝書を受け継ぐことになったより突然5人のギャングがやってきた。奴ら俺を守ろうとした父ちゃんを、そしてとうとう見つけ出してしまったんだ。大切なラクーナの秘伝書を奴ら俺様の全てを奪いやがった。きっと中に書かれた技を使って 悪いことをしでかすに違いねえ。そして俺様は一人ぼっち、町の孤児院に入った。だがここで素晴らしい仲間に出会ったんだ。天才発明家、頼れる相棒、ベントレー。 そしてマーへ。食いしん坊でちょっとドジだが、まあ憎めない弟分さ。仲間と一緒に俺様は父ちゃんの仇を討ち、そして秘伝書を取り返す。クーパーの名前に恥じない義賊になれるか、それとも失敗してご先祖の顔に泥を塗るのか。さあ、俺様たちの運命はどっちだ。
This is quite of a creepy thing what I just watched right there. It is a very weird bullshit. Now, in the next part, we will get the last thing that we are supposed to get for the Thievius Raccoonus, which is going to be held right by the duel by the dragon. So. Thanks for watching, guys. Don't forget to drop a comment and or a like and subscribe if you haven't. And we shall see you in the next part of Sly Cooper. So, goodbye.